When you have Airtable with many tables and a lot of data, getting simple insights is not easy. Wouldn't it be nice to use GPT to query your Airtable data and help you with the analysis? In this video, I'll show you how I am using my custom chat GPT to search data, create chart, and analyze Airtable. I'll show you how I build it and how you can test it out right now. And if you watch until the end, I will also show you how incredibly easy it is to adjust my custom GPT actions to your own Airtable base. Stick around. Hi, this is Greg from Business Automated. So let's take a look at this custom GPT. Before we start testing it out, let's take a look at the Airtable base that we have connected to it. So this is a sample base that contains a list of different early stage VC funds that invest in early stage startups. And you can see here the name of the fund and their website and things like location and so on. And then there's a second table which contains amount of money that they have raised for their funds together with the year when that specific fund was raised. Okay, and there are also some additional notes. So now let's start with our Airtable analyst, and you will see that here I have some questions that are predefined, and I have actually set those questions here, so it's easier to start with something. So let's start with sort of a general questions. What tables are available inside of my Airtable base? Once we click that, you will see that Airtable analyst will make an action that will require a confirmation from our side, or not if I have confirmed that before. But if you'll be using this for the first time, it will ask you here to click allow to make this request. As you will see here, talk to means that the analyst has sent a special request using one of the actions that we have predefined to this specific base. And this is the information that we have received back. And you will see that here we have the name of the firm. So we have table called firms, and it displays all the field that we have inside of there. And it also is mentioning that we have the second table. So this is a sort of basic information that we would have about this specific base. But let's come back to those original questions. I have just started a new chat with the Airtable analyst. So this is the original question that we have. I will now ask to list the top 10 funds by the amount of money that have been raised by those funds. And as you will see, it has executed one action, and here it is executing another action for which it is asking me to confirm that we are okay with doing this action. So this time we'll click allow, and you can see that it's making multiple requests to Airtable. And once we click here, you can actually see that it has made two different requests to Airtable. In one of them, it was asking to sort by the amount of capital raised, if you are familiar with how sorting works in Airtable. And in the second one, it has actually filtered by formula to get the linked records of the funds that were linked over here. So you can see that this way it has basically listed the top 10 funds that we would have over here. So what we can ask right now, we can ask it to make a bar chart. And you will see that currently we got a bar chart, which we actually can copy over here and reuse in a presentation, for example. When we click on the view analysis, it is showing us actually the code that was used to generate this chart. What we can do here, you can see that these are funds that raise money in different capital rounds. What we can do, we can also ask it to do this for specific rounds. So what we can say here, and here you will see that at this stage we have got list of funds that have raised money in the round 5. You can actually see that here inside of the request, it has added additional filter by formula. So it has queried from Airtable only the funds that were in the round 1. So you can see that this is actually quite good with understanding the Airtable formula. Let's ask it one more complicated question, which will require more data. And as you will see, for this request, for this specific question, it will need to ask more requests to Airtable because we will have to download more pages from inside of the Airtable base. And you will see for this specific request, it has actually made a question to Airtable where it is asking for only the field called locations. And based on that location field, it will provide us back with a chart. All right, we have gotten the response over here, and you can see it is a little bit like working with an intern. We need to tell it a couple of things, like for example, so you just need to remind it to group some of the smaller cities into one and make color nicer because it's very difficult to see. Obviously my mistake, because I was not precise enough into telling it. It did make the pie chart, but it did not make it according to aesthetic standard. It would if I would tell it to do so explicitly. And now you can see we have a nicer pie chart with some of the smaller cities grouped into others. Okay, so now let's take a look how this is working and how this is built. So for that, we're gonna click here inside of the analyst, and because I created this one, I will have a feature which is called Edit GPT. Here we'll go to the configure screen, and you will see that here I'm having some of the basic description, which you can see over here. So this is just what shows up over here. The crucial part is actually what shows up here inside of the instructions. Then these are some questions that are predefined that you can add over here. And here the crucial part are the custom actions that we have added over here. So once you click on the custom actions, you will see that here inside of the schema, I have a definition for Airtable API that defines two specific endpoints. It defines endpoint called getBaseSchema, which allows GPT to see what are the tables and fields that you have inside of the database. And the second one is listTableRecords. This is the second API endpoint that allows to retrieve information from specific table. Once you are here, you can test it. And this specific testing view is very good to see what is the exactly response that was received from the specific GPT. And you can see that I'm getting exactly information about all the fields inside of the specific tables and so on. So you can see here exactly what are the responses to a given question. And let's test, for example, this endpoint. Here you can also see what sort of question and what sort of parameters are going to be sent into this specific API. Okay, so one more element here is that we are also using API key authentication. So I will show you how to set it up in a second. So we have two different API endpoints, but for this to work, we also need to inform it what is the base ID. And the way that I'm doing this is using the instruction field. So once we maximize the instruction, you will see that here, this is some general instruction for what the assistant is and what it does. And the base ID that this assistant is looking for is this specific base ID. So I have not defined this inside of the API. I have defined this in the instruction, so it is easy to adjust it over here. And the next element is there's a couple of questions that are important for the GPT to know. So for example, whenever it sees a specific field called offset, that means that there are more records to retrieve. This means that you need to make another request to get another page from the API. I have also added a prompt that reminds the GPT not to return record IDs as the names, because sometimes it returns the names of record IDs. Instead, I'm asking it to specifically look up human readable names for those record IDs, so this is more readable for us. And whatever you would like to do, whatever is the wrong responses that you're getting from your GPT, this is a place where you can kind of point it in the right direction. So this is how I have set it up for my base, and now I will show you how very easy it is to basically create a customized GPT like this directly to operate on your own Airtable base. So once you start with your default GPT screen, you need to go to Explore, and inside of Explore, you have to create a custom GPT. Click here, and you can either follow the builder, so you could tell it what it's supposed to do, and it will create some of the generic description. You can say yes, and you can also ask it to create a profile image. Okay, I think that's fine for now. You can ask it to fine-tune the image if you'd like something else. And what we will do over here, we will basically use some of the data that I have saved over here to customize the assistant. So this is less important, but the instructions here are quite important. So you can find a link in the description to the article where I will post it, and you'll be able to copy that description from the article. And you can see that this whole description here as instruction, this is quite important because it relates to a couple things like what is the base ID, but it's also reminding it to always check the schema of the base before asking questions about tables and fields, so it doesn't hallucinate the names of those fields and tables as it would do otherwise. And it also has some other useful things. So this is this part. And now the only thing is, since we're not using image generation for this, I'm just turning it off. And here we'll ask create new action. And what I will do over here, I will literally go right here, copy the whole code over here, paste the code over here, and you will see that it will recognize that there are two actions. Before it will work, we need to add authentication. So inside of the settings, you have to select API key, type better, and to get the API key, you would need to go to the Airtable developers and then create slash token. So you will see this once you go to API inside of Airtable. And here you will have to create a new token. So click create token, and for the scopes, you need to select read. There's no need to be doing anything about read, but you can also do schema basis read. So you need those two specific permissions, and then you need to select a base that you would like to be connected to this specific API token. I'm creating token, and this is a single-use token. What I will do over here, I will copy paste this token right here, I will save it. And before I can test it out, I need to go back. Make sure that you don't click on the button over here, as I just did a second ago, but you scroll all the way here. If you click back, it will just do not save anything. Make sure that you click save. And at the moment, you have three different options where you would like to publish it. If you select people with link, you need to add the privacy policy because of the custom actions. The same for public. We will save it only for me, so click confirm, and we will go back to the step over here. And inside of the step right here, we will need to update the app ID. The way you are getting the app ID is you go to your Airtable and you select the same base that you have granted permission, and you copy this part over here. So now it has access to this particular base. We can close it, and we can actually test it from here. This was actually not a relevant question, so just let's use this one. And here you will see that it's making a request to Airtable, and you can click allow or always allow. So once you click always allow, it will not ask for that particular request. And this way you can test that it has successfully connected to your Airtable, and that's it. And you can ask it for questions that relate to your Airtable base. And if you would like to share it, you need to add here inside of the custom actions. If you have the custom actions, you would need to add the privacy policy. And then once you click update, you have an option to share this with other people. So I will also share this link to my specific GPT with you so that you can play around and test it. And it will be online as long as it does not hit my API limits on Airtable. All right, I hope that you found this video useful. If so, please like and subscribe and share it with your friends. And stay tuned for more business automation videos. Take good care.